Hello and welcome to Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning and I'm standing on the shore of Death Valley's Great Lake. Death Valley is renowned as being one of the hottest places in the world, as one of the farthest below sea level. The deepest part of the valley is 87 meters below sea level, just about 282 feet. Death Valley started forming about 2 million years ago as the surrounding mountain ranges started pulling apart and opening up this deep valley in the earth. And because it was the Ice Age, many of the surrounding mountains were covered in vast snowfields, and the increased rainfall caused these many valleys in the area to fill up with water. Death Valley contained a lake called Lake Manly, named after an early pioneer, and at its highest point was over 600 feet deep. This enormous lake stretched for over 120 miles north to south and as many as 20 miles wide. So 600 feet of water once filled this valley behind me. This shoreline I'm standing on now is one of the few remaining intact beaches from an earlier lower stand of this lake. This colossal lake that filled Death Valley existed for about 1 million years during the last ice age. It reached its highest point of 600 feet deep about 11,000 years ago. By the end of the last ice age, about 10,000 years ago, the lake had dried up. What I'm standing on now is a beach from when the lake existed at about 400 feet deep. We know that this is a beach because of the way the rocks are rounded by water action and how they're sorted in this nice ridge. This is one of a very few intact shorelines from the old lake levels, because many of these ancient shorelines have been destroyed by erosion, including flash floods off of the many nearby mountains. So even though I'm in the middle of one of North America's driest deserts right now, this deep lake created a shoreline like that of any lake along the slopes of its mountains. Despite the fact that many of these ancient shorelines have been eroded away and no longer exist, a few areas exist on high cliffs above the valley floor that exhibit mineral deposits and wave-cut terraces that mark the high levels of the water. This has been Better Geology. My name is Andrew Dunning. Thank you for watching.